if you've practiced enough on your own to realize that this thought feels on the path and this thought feels off, so this is where I'm going. And then this thought feels on the path and this feels off, and so this is the way I'm going. And this thought feels on the path and this one's off. And so until you are solid on your path. And of course, there are going to be new things that come up that take you over there a little bit. But soon you'll get so good at recognizing it early on that the momentum isn't big enough that you have no choice. So how is it? Hear this. Oh, this is what we came to help you remember. When you find alignment, which is so sweet, and then you lose it for a little bit that isn't so sweet, and you find alignment that is so sweet, and then you lose it and it isn't so sweet. And then something big happens before you've really found it, so it's really not sweet. And then you're kind of on that, so it's really not sweet. And then it's really sour, and then it really sucks, and then you're really suffering. It doesn't take too much of that before you remember, hey, enough. So sometimes we acknowledge you have to have the experience of really being off your path before you make a self-determining statement, not going to do that again, not going to do that again, not right. Going to do that again, not going to do that again. Well, you're doing it all the time. You say you're not going to do it, but you really mean it. I'm going to find this at the earlier subtle stages. I'm not going to be dragged until the skin is all off my body before I get back on my path again. Next time, I'm going to be more aware. And so gradually, you come to this experience, to this knowing, to this determination, to this willingness, to this wantingness, to this desire to be in alignment first and foremost. Because you see, there are a lot of things that you don't run the risk of getting yourself just beat up badly. And so you play with it. Oh, this isn't so bad. Oh, this isn't so bad. What we want you to know is it's going to get worse. It's going to get worse. Serve yourself, find alignment, care about your path no matter what, and practice on the little things till you get better and better at it. So that when the big things come, you're ready for it. And most of all, Esther said to us the other day, Abraham, I'm having these feelings of regret about this that didn't go well, and 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 this didn't go well. And what she's talking about, this person I fired, and this person I fired, and this person I fired, and this person I don't play with. And we said, Esther, path of least resistance says you find the path that feels good to you. What you keep doing, those of you, you lovely people who want to serve others, is that even though you know this isn't best for you, if it's better for them, you try it. And even though it's not best for you, if it's better for them, you try it. And even though if it's not best for you, but it's better for them, you try it. And pretty soon, you are so separated from who you are and what you want, and now you're full of resentment at them.
Right.
You see? Just trying to help you out. That's what we're saying. It backfires 100% of the time. So what we wanted to say to Esther, to soothe her, and what we want to say to all of you is, you're all doing the best that you can every step along the way. But if you will put into this formula of life that you are living, if you will put into this formula your awareness that you've launched the rockets and that the source within you knows your path and that the source within you is calling you to your path, and when you are moving in the direction of your path, it always feels wonderful. And when you let someone else say, they don't say it just this way, but it's what they mean, and they don't mean to mean it, but it's what they mean, and they don't mean to say it, but it's what they say, and they don't mean to mean it, but it's what they mean. Don't do what's best for you, do what's best for me. If you love me enough, you'll do what's best for me. And we say, you'll reach the place where as you find alignment and you find that true love, that you will then have love for them unconditionally. But if you're doing what's best for them before you find alignment, you will never have alignment. And then what you give to them will not be unconditional love. It will be conditional love. It will be justified love. It will be rationalized love. It will be you owe this to me and I owe this to you love. It will be looking for love in all the wrong places. It will be trying to fill a void with something that could never fill the void. The only thing that ever fills you up is your alignment with who you really are, you see. We think you got that.
Yeah.
Sort of?
Yeah.
Your life is going to be full of lots of opportunities to see if you got it. And it's going to be fun because in the experiences where you got it, it's going to be so sweet. Oh, and then the experiences where you didn't get it, it will be to the degree that you let the momentum go before you remembered and got it again, it'll be that not sweet. But the big news is you're now in control of the way you feel. You're now not dependent on other people to do something that they were never assigned to do. You're going to find freedom in the only place that it ever was, in your own alignment, in your own resources, in your own empowerment, in your own enlightenment.